What's up, Internet? This is Random Game Critic, and welcome back to Spyro the Dragon. Last time, we made it through Metalhead, and now, this is Wild Flight, take two. Yeah, I failed already, but I cut that whole thing out because I want to do this all in one go. Because I kind of need to do it all in one go. Anyways, what I was saying is that this stage is actually, in the failed recording, this stage is pretty linear, really. Once you take care of the bullets and the arches, everything else kind of just falls into place after that. The arts especially, but the boats, it's kind of tracked down the last two guys, which I just did there. Let's get this arc, turn around and get him, and go for the chests now. Now, one thing I was talking about is that, the music for this stage. It's pretty complicated music, and you might be wondering, like, how long it may have taken somebody to compose something like this. Well, I'll be sure to link this if you're interested, but there's a video I found on YouTube where there's an interview with Stewart Copeland about the Spyro the Dragon music. And I'm not sure if it's actually the way it worked or not, but the interview made it look like he composed this music to this stage, like, right away. Like, there's a part where he goofs around with like, his musical instruments, and he makes this song. I'm pretty sure it's this anyway. I'll link it in the description for anyone who's interested. But there's a part in the interview where it looks like he composes this song, and it's just a matter of seconds. I'm not sure if that's actually what happened or not, but interesting, though. Check it out. And you get to see the flashy animation that you almost never get to see because I always screw something up at the end. And Yezors. Yeah, as you can see, I got everything but the plagues in my last attempt. So I will not try again because there's no point in doing that when you get everything. And one thing, I always forget to like show what the balloonist says, but like, since I've already been to World 5 and I skipped over completely to get to World 6, but the balloonist pretty much says like, wow, you rescued all those dragons really fast. I didn't think you could do it. I barely had time to patch up that leak. Now, I can go to Peacekeepers or Beastmakers, Dreamweavers. But we are going to Dreamweavers next time. Ow. Next time on Spyro the Dragon, we are going to the fifth world of the game, and actually, which pretty much the last world of the game as far as this LP is concerned. I'll see you guys in the Dreamweavers homeworld.